Tom Brady, the Cinderella story of the NFL.
Deep to right field, number 44.
The man who definitely needs no introduction, number 4, Bobby Orr.
The Celtics are the world champion.
Number 9, Hall of Famer.
Clemens has set a major league record for strikeouts.
Boy, he can make that puck through crack.
We are all Patriots, and tonight, the Patriots are world champions.
Thank you, Boston. I love you.
Stanley Cup Finals at Boston Garden.
It's the Red Sox. It's the Yankees. It's Game 7. It's time for some serious baseball.
Boston wins the fourth game.
I hope they know who won the World Championship.
Back to full. Red Sox fans have longed to hear it. The Boston Red Sox are world champions.
Williams swing, and there's a long drive to deep right.
Now that's a steal by Burr. Underneath the DJ, lays it in.
Bauer scrambles away from one hit. Looks, uncorks a deep one for the end zone. Phelan is down there.
Oh, he got it!
I think in terms of the Celtics, we've been blessed with one of the greatest franchises, if not the greatest franchise, historically speaking, in all of basketball.
I feel proud of the fact that I'm from this area, and you got the best football team in the world 3 out of the last 4 years.
Havlicek stole a ball was an all-time moment. Orr's goal was a great, great moment. We've had a lot of them, and we're really lucky. I mean, there are some towns that haven't exactly had all those moments.
Champions of the American League East in 1990.
Ainge finds an open bird. Takes Rambis. 1 second. It's out.
Whatever happened to the Los Angeles dynasty? Here's where it is, right here.
That's a dumbass question. You go. Give me a break with that crap.
Where I'm from, not very many people know about me. It's very exciting for me and my family, and I'll do the best I possibly can to help the Celtics win.
It's just everything is starting to fall into place. I hope you all realize it.
Kicks telling him, take that thing and skate.
Skate it, baby. Skate it.
We'll follow you.
There's a history of New York opposing Boston, culturally, in art, in everything.
Imagine if we win. I guess they will turn the city upside down if we win the World Series here.
What can I say? Just dip my heart and call the Yankees my daddies.
Dude, seriously, are we going to play in the playoff against somebody else? Every year it's Yankee in Boston. What's the deal, Les?
I'm not sure I can think of any scenario more enjoyable than making 55,000 people from New York shut up.
Matsui, swing and a drive to right field. This ball is against the wall.
It's Bernie Williams. Ground ball up the middle, base hit. Here comes Matsui. He rounds third. He's in to score. 2-0 Yankees.
Jeter scores. Rodriguez coming home. Sheffield around third. He's winning. Here's the throw to the plate. It is offline. A three-run double for Matsui, and the Yankees lead 5-0.
5-0 Yankees.
You can see the frustration there on the part of Schilling. You know that Terry Francona has to be concerned. I'm wondering if he did not do something to that right ankle.
I mean, this is not about me. This is or me braving through something. This is about us and winning the world championship. And if I can't give them better than I gave them today, I won't take the ball again.
Swing and a miss, he got it. And the New York Yankees are 2 wins away from another appearance in the World Series.
And we know our backs to the wall, but we haven't played our best games yet.
At all discouraging losing with your two aces in the first two
games? Well, we're built on a team. We're not built on just two people.
Swing and a drive deep to left. Way back. This ball is gone. Into the monster seats for a three-run homer.
This is going to be a different kind of game than game two.
Pitch is hit up the middle and through for a base hit by Matsui. Rodriguez scores. Matsui greets Embry with a base hit. 14-6 for the Yankees.
Pounding Red Sox fans into submission.
So I don't think I need to go drop the Newt Rockne on them. They're smart enough. I know they call themselves idiots. They're smart enough to know if we lose, we go home.
He goes. The pitch taken outside. Here's the throw. Stolen base, Dave Roberts, tying run at second base. He went in with a hand tag. Jeter took the throw. It was close, very close at second.
Off the middle, base hit. Roberts running third, waved in. Bernie Williams throwing home. It's cut off, and the game is tied. The Red Sox tie it in the bottom of the ninth.
Drive, deep to right, way back, and this ball is gone. Jump on his back, fellas. The Red Sox win. David Ortiz, another walk-off home run.
It's 3-1. We set out today to win. Now, our objective is to win tomorrow.
Little blooper, center field. That drops down for a hit. Here comes Damon. He's in to score, and the Red Sox win it in 14 innings. They're going to the Bronx. There's no giving up now. Do you really want to give this all away? Can't you ever see things in a different way? Someday. No giving up now. Such a beautiful thing to throw away. You should think things through before you give it up now. Swing and a miss. He threw a fastball by him. Game 7 coming up here at Yankee Stadium.
The easy thing to do would have been to give up, but we don't do anything easy in this clubhouse.
One swings and hits that one down the right field line, deep into the corner, sailing, it is gone! Johnny Damon, a grand slam in Game 7, and the Red Sox have blown it open early. Unbelievable! 6-0 Boston. My goodness.
Swinging a ground ball to second base. Hokie Reese has it. He throws to first, and the Red Sox have won the American League pennant.
They pulled off the miracle. The most stunning comeback in baseball history.
It's finally come, Boston. We've done it.
I mean, Morgan is livid.
All this negativity that's in this town sucks.
Here it is. Perry's going to put it in play. It goes now to Hurd. The shot. It's good. And it goes into another overtime.
And we welcome you to snowy Foxborough Stadium.
We have a real honest snowstorm. It looks like a snow globe got turned upside down. Back five steps, looking left, going to the end zone, and he's got a man. Touchdown.
Beautiful.
James Jett.
Tom Brady is looking very much like a kid who's played just 14 games.
And wow. He nailed it. Sebastian Janikowski has put New England down 10.
You look at the scoreboard and you realize how improbable it's going to be that the Patriots are going to be able to come back.
Shotgun for Brady. Back to throw, rushed, hit, fumble the football. It's still on the floor, and the Raiders have recovered.
Yeah, I was throwing the ball. Looking to the left, throwing it. I was going to throw it, and he hit me as I was throwing. How do you like that?
You know, it looked like his arm was going forward, but, you know, at that point, you just never know. So, you know, you're kind of sitting there holding your breath and praying, you know, hoping, you know, the season is kind of pivotal on that one call, and fortunately for us, it went our way.
Adam Vinatieri with a chance to tie the game.
That was a game that you kind of figured, okay, they'll lose this game, they'll be back next year.
It's a 45-yard field goal try.
We never make these kind of kicks.
My goodness.
On the right hash mark, if there was one, to tie with 30 seconds left. The kick is low, the kick is limping, but the kick is good. With 27 seconds remaining,
I think that was a changing moment in Patriots history. I mean, they were doing well and everything, but I think that the Patriots were redefined in their history with that kick.
I just didn't know if he had the right shoes on. I thought he might need skates to kick that one through.
Vinatieri's field goal tied it. Here we are in overtime. Shotgun to Brady. He flips it in the right flat. Redmond on a screen. He breaks a tackle. First down on the right sideline. J.R. Redmond. Brady hands it to Smith. Oh, he's Smith coming right, breaking tackles. He's got a first down to the 10-yard line.
What if we pulled this off? What if we somehow win this game?
Good snap, good hold. The kick is up. The Patriots have won. And New England will advance to the AFC Championship game. Sunday.
Oh, man. Watch him hide his eyes.
Hey, what's your favorite ring? You know, as you say, the next one.
Roar winds. Here it comes. Fly ball to deep left. Yastrzemski is going hard. Way back, way back. And he dives and makes a tremendous catch.
I absolutely love to watch those teams play. Here's the hard-working Celtics, you know, the gritty guys, you know, against the punks from Detroit.
There was incredible animosity between these two teams.
And there was nothing to like about the Pistons.
You know, they just couldn't like those guys because not only the way they played, but the way they just acted.
I hated them. I couldn't stand them. You know, Lambeer and that group, they were just, made me puke.
As a Celtic fan, I never liked Isaiah Thomas.
So I didn't like Isaiah. I didn't like his act.
These guys really didn't like one another.
The biggest villain of all.
Bill Lambeer.
Bill Lambeer.
Bill Lambeer.
Because you felt that Lambeer was always flopping, he was always complaining, and he was always doing dirty things. He'll be despised in this region forever.
I think Johnny Most had a lot to do with making villains out of a lot of those guys, and I think, you know, the more we listened to him, the more we hated the opposition of certain players.
There is a violent, violent knockdown by Lambeer, and Burr just smacked him. Oh, my. Oh, the yellow, gunless way they do things here. They have been called a dirty ball club, and I can see why. This is a typical, disgusting display by Rodman, Lambeer, and Isaiah Thomas. And they told me I shouldn't say bad things about Isaiah, and I say, why not? All right, 14 seconds left. On the left, it goes to Bird. Bird guarded by Mahorn, drives around him, goes on in, and the ball gets knocked out of bounds by Ainge. Oh, they call it the other way.
The whole emotion of the building just went gone. And, I mean, it was stone silent.
I remember just thinking the game was over, and all of a sudden, the ball's thrown in, and here comes Larry Bird.
And now there's a steal by Bird. Underneath the DJ, he lays it in. Right at 1 second left. What a play by Bird. Bird stole the inbounding pass.
See Bird steal that ball like that, you know, in a pass from Isaiah, it's just a beautiful thing.
What a play by Bird. And Boston has a one-point lead with 1 second left. Oh, my, this place is going crazy.
Bill Russell, 30 points and 40, I repeat, 40 rebounds.
Stolen by Jenny. He's in. He shoots. He scores.
I look out in the crowd and I see one thing that typifies our season. Moses does he.
I'm a fan. I fall in love with these guys. and I want them all to stick around. I wish we kept Nomar. I wish we kept Malloy. What do I know? I don't know anything. I know I love the guys that play for the team, and when they play well, I want them to stay.
Take my hand, come with me into this crystal scenery, and wait till I retain a ticket. You will never have the time. I would love to change your mind. You were there, and it was good in the beginning.
They want you to cook the dinner. At least they ought to let you shop for some of the groceries.
I mean, I think our groceries are pretty good.
We just have a little philosophical difference.
I never had any differences with them.
You know, it was a big day in Boston history. I mean, they traded away the franchise.
I was proud to put that uniform on and what it represented.
I'm going to miss him as a ball player, miss him as a friend.
We've lost a great player in Nomar Garcia-Parra.
How's it? I'll drink to that.
All the players I've released in my career, this easily would be the hardest.
You know, as one of those guys, you look into his eyes before every game, and you knew exactly what you were going to get.
Curtis Martin is one of the finest young men you'll ever meet.
This decision gives us options and an opportunity to strengthen our team this season, as well as for the future.
I've always enjoyed the rivalry, and the Red Sox are the enemy now.
And I requested that I be traded to a Stanley Cup contender.
Has the ball in three-point land. It's off! A three-point field goal by Larry Bird! This ball game coming down right into the hands of Bird and Dominique.
Sometimes you have to get hit in the face with a skunk three or four times before you smell it.
Light it up. Matt Allback.
The greatest moment in New England sports history. It's when Flutie threw the pass.
Here's your ball game, folks, as Flutie takes the snap.
Flutie at that point was like the closest thing to a hero Boss had had in football. Just this guy, I mean, what was he, 5'10", and he's just scrambling around the field, just throwing the ball everywhere.
The strong safety moved up, got over the tackle. He's your man.
Right.
But he was right over the tackle. He's still your man, though.
They got caught nickel.
Slipped out of my hand.
I know.
It looked like a Flutieism.
People have watched me since high school. They saw my college career. They know a lot about me personally,
So that made it fun.
I admired Flutie. I liked his style. I liked his whole approach.
And he was just this, you know, fiery guy who obviously wasn't the normal quarterback size, who just wouldn't be stopped. I think he captured New England's attention because BC football hadn't been good for a long time.
Let me tell you, that's a big win. We're going to go someplace big. There's no question.
Yeah! 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 Yeah!
Woo! Miami was this huge beast of a team that we thought there was no way little BC could compete with them. They were so fast and had such a great offense and played nationally ranked teams every week. And BC was just this little team that, you know, independent, that beat a few teams here and there.
We weren't intimidated by that whole picture of Miami, Bernie Kosar, that whole team, defending national champions, all that stuff. To us, that was fun.
Time was running out, everything was on the line, and he made the pass.
I thought we had a legitimate shot of getting it across midfield, and then we're throwing one for the end zone.
Here's your ball game, folks, as Flutie takes the snap. He drops straight back, has some time. Now he scrambles away from one hit. Looks, uncorks a deep one for the end zone. Phelan is down there.
Oh, he got it!
Did he get it?
He got it!
Touchdown! 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 Touchdown, Boston College! He did it! He did it! Flutie did it! He got Phelan in the end zone! Touchdown!
Special player, and did it all at BC, and that's where it started for him.
The dreams are that you're gonna have a great series and win, and the nightmares are that you're gonna let the winning run score on a ground ball through your legs. So.
The city of Boston. It's been a long time coming, huh?
Plays it near the line and lost it. Wesley is away. Kevin Lowe back. Wesley, rebound, score!
And the wind blowing out. We've had three homers tonight, all the center field. There it goes, the long drive. If it stays fair, home run!
There was a little bit of that them versus us. The Red Sox were the ragtag team, and they were the heavy underdogs against the big red machine.
Nothing can equal Game 6, 1975.
Well, tell me, did you sail across the sun? Did you make it to the Milky Way?
Bernie Carbo, swinging at the first couple of pitches, looked like a sushi chef, carving up that meat at the Makaha or someplace around Porter Square. And then bang.
Deep center field, way back, way back. We're tied up.
And the night is alive, and so are the Red Sox.
It was a sea of people. You're just jammed in out there, and you know something special is happening, even as a 14-year-old kid.
And then, the bottom of the 12th, Pudge Fisk from New England, grew up in New Hampshire. Boom. Crowd on the old rooftop and out in the streets lingered for hours after that game.
I've forgotten completely about Game 7. I mean, why even bother?
Church bells all over New England ringing past midnight into October 23rd, 1975. That, my friends, that was an electric moment.
This is a tie.
Money.
Yo!
Larry Bird!
To analyze this game in one word, it was will.
I think the guys like Carl Yastrzemski, Tom Brady, Larry Bird, Kevin McHale, Bobby Orr, I mean, these guys were just revered throughout sport as the best who ever played. And I think that that, you know, reflects well on people from New England because they feel that in their lifetime they got to see some of the greatest who ever played the game.
Back over to Worthy, and it's picked off. Toss the head as he lays it off and out.
Clemens has set a major league record for strikeouts in a game.
Park holding, cuts in front, shoots, and scores! Rob Park breaking the all-time defenseman scoring record. He was tied with Orr.
In left point.
Esposito about to score! Number 500!
Two-strike pitch to Delgado. Swing and a miss! He struck him out. 300 strikeouts for Pedro Martinez.
Another jumper and hit it at the buzzer. Bird has 60 points.
Runners go, pitches a curve, hits it deep left field, and
Wesley to Neely, shot scores. Number 50, Cam Neely on a power play.
Well, Jack, I wanted to play. I knew it was my last game, and I don't have to save up for next year or anything. And
Ray Leonard is hurt in the corner.
Our next guest is the greatest player in the history of the National Hockey League. Number 4, Bobby Orr.
My mother is here tonight, and she's never been in Boston Garden, so it must be a very special night. So thank you all.
Sudden, he's got running room. Getting around Harris, putting it, scores! It's 3-2, and Orr has scored a shorthanded goal, his 100th point. That's Bobby Orr's 100th point of the season. No other defenseman in the National Hockey League history has ever done it.
We watched Orr come. We all knew about him when he was 12 years old. We heard about it.
Every pond in New England was filled with potential Bobby Orrs.
I mean, I remember going out with figure skates, for crying out loud, playing hockey on a frozen pond because of the Boston Bruins.
And that one whistled wide. Ory for the Bruins, tied up by Ecclestone and Berenson. Westfall rolled it in front. Sanderson tried a shot that was wide, and Keenan cleared it but not out. Bobby Orr behind the net to Sanderson. Orr! Bobby Orr! Scores in the Boston Bruins! The time of the goal, 40 seconds of sudden death overtime. Bobby Orr, what a moment for the Bruins and their fans.
Only guy I think that deserves to score the winning goal in the Stanley Cup is Bobby Orr.
Bobby and his dad, Doug, picked. This is the happiest day of my life. This is the happiest day of my life. I couldn't wish for anything else.
Hey, no, hold up now, eh?
What are you going to say? Number four, Bobby Orr.
Larry Bird's not walking through that door, fans. Kevin McHale's not walking through that door, and Robert Parrish is not walking through that door. And if you expect them to walk through the door, they're going to be gray and old.
Deep and on its way. It is no longer a scoreless game. A two-run homer for Trot Nixon.
Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you please rise. Today, the people of New England and baseball fans throughout America and the world have lost a man who was the definition of a modern-day hero. The great Ted Williams passed away this morning.
His goal was always to walk down the street and have people say, there goes the best damn hitter who ever lived.
The last at bat has been so studied, so written about, so mythologized that it's hard to know what was real and what wasn't real.
One out, nobody on, last of the eighth inning. Jack Fisher into his windup, here's the pitch. Williams swings, and there's a long drive to deep right. That ball is going, and it is gone. A home run for Ted Williams. In his last time at bat in the Major League.
Nobody else could do that. Just say, I'm going to hit a home run my last at bat.
Brown takes it from the 45 over to the left side to the 50. 45 down the middle over to the 40, 35. Breaks another tackle. 30, 20, 15, 10. He will go the distance. Touchdown, New England.
Now I know what the Celtics mystique is about. It's about red. He brought in people like Bill Russell, John Havlicek, Larry Bird. He made it happen.
It's over. The Celtics are the world champion.
The one guy that really, really stuck out for me during those days was John Havlicek.
Kamala turns and stuffs the ball. There are 5 seconds left. Now Russell is...
He loses the ball off the support, and Boston's only leading by 1 point.
I was on the bench. They called timeout, and I went into the huddle, and Bill Russell said to the rest of the team, "Guys, I screwed up. Somebody get me off the hook."
Johnny Most jumped out of my radio. And I can remember the room I was in. I can remember jumping out, but I can't believe it. Because I was prepared for them to lose that game.
He gets it out deep, and Havlicek steals it over to Stan Jones. Havlicek stole the ball. It's all over. It's all over. Johnny Havlicek is being mobbed by the fans. It's all over. Johnny Havlicek stole the ball. Boy, what a play by Havlicek!
Havlicek stole the ball, became a symbol of these miraculous finishes of the Celtics.
Now that's a steal by Bird!
Underneath to McDonald, a ball away. Glenn McDonald!
Back over to Worthy, and it's picked off!
Stop and pop off the glass, it's gone!
We love it!
Now Billy Rohr gets ready to work to Joe Pepitone.
Seasting and Sampson. And now Dennis Johnson. And a melee is broken out here.
Every time I see a retired number go up, I always get a tear in my eye, you know, because they do it so well. And these players have so much class. It's always a special moment.
But I want to tell you, as far as Ted Williams is concerned, baseball's the greatest in Boston, and the fans are the greatest. I salute you.
I've made some mistakes in my life. One mistake I did not make was to stay here and not leave.
I would like to announce my retirement from boxing at this time.
'Cause the man on the outstaken is final bow by phone.
I have been asked many times this year what I will miss most about no longer playing.
Not be coming back to play basketball. So as far as I'm concerned, I gave my heart, my body, my soul to the Celtics, and hopefully we can continue to have a good relationship.
I hope you can bear with me here.
his final bow. A
couple signs I saw, and they said, "Say it ain't so, yes." I wish it wasn't.
I now know for sure that my leg cannot handle playing. If I had to do it all over again, I know I would do it the same way.
I just want everyone to know how much I love the game and what it meant to me.
There's only 24 minutes left. What more can I say? Thank you, Boston. I love you.
I remember that, you know, they were talking about the Patriots having no chance and that they were going to get their tails kicked all around the field.
The first thing I remember about that game, I think it was Tabucky Jones.
Lost the ball, the Patriots have it, they scoop it up. This is Tabucky Jones.
I would have put the Patriots up like 20 points, so that was going to be the game. I think I jumped over the couch onto a couple of my friends at that point. And then so I look up, and all of a sudden, you know, there's that penalty flag.
Flag on the play, I believe.
And then all of a sudden, a game that was pretty much in hand, you know, touchdown pass here, pass to Ricky Pohl here. And holy smokes, this game's tied. It was seemed kind of like classic Boston sports blowing it at the end.
Then came to a, you know, quarterback who played about 8 or 9 games. Last game of the year happens to be the Super Bowl, and he's got to take a team, you know, 45 yards or whatever to get in field goal position.
And now with no timeouts, I think that the Patriots, with this field position, you have to just run the clock out. You have to play for overtime now. I don't think you want to force anything here. You don't want to do anything stupid.
And you could see that Brady wanted none of that.
I don't agree with what the Patriots are doing right here.
That's what we do as analysts. We make, you know, we say dumb things.
Now I kind of like what the Patriots are doing.
On every play, you think they're gonna fumble, they're gonna intercept, they're gonna, you know, he's gonna throw an interception, that he just keeps moving down the field, moving down the field.
We were sitting with a group of people in Aruba who were all from New England, and you're sitting there watching this, and you're going, is this really happening? Are they gonna, you know, are they gonna win this game? Are they gonna beat this team? And look at this kid, you know, it's like nothing bothers him.
I'll tell you, what Tom Brady just did gives me goosebumps.
This would be from 48 yards out.
Vinatieri's field goal try for the win is good. It's good. It's good. And the New England Patriots have won Super Bowl 36.
Been a great win for you,
Jack. One more time, one more time. Set scores!
Oh, there's no curse. There's no curse.
I thought the curse was bullshit all along.
I think it's silly. I don't think few things in my life have ever annoyed me more than the curse.
I've never been on a team, played on a team, or been around a team as a broadcaster with the Red Sox who felt that they are cursed because they play for the Boston Red Sox or because Babe Ruth went to the Yankees. I don't think anybody felt that way.
If it takes another 86 years, I'll eat that camera.
I think they get sick of hearing about it. There's no question about that. And thank God they don't have to hear about it anymore.
The 1-0 pitch, here it is. Swinging a ground ball, stabbed by Folk, he has it. He underhands to first, and the Boston Red Sox are the world champions. For the first time in 86 years, the Red Sox have won baseball's world championship. Can you believe it?
There's never been a championship in any sport that tied more people from different generations together than the Red Sox. And that's why it's different.
I'm 15 for a moment, caught in between 10 and 20, and I'm just dreaming, counting the ways to where you are. I'm 22 for a moment, and she feels better than ever, and we're on fire, making our way back from my heart.
And I bet you every guy on this team that won this year, Damon, Pedro, all these guys, would say that those other guys that came before, the guys I mentioned, were just a bigger part of it as the guys that's here today.
There's never a wish better than this when you only got 100 years to live.
Here's hoping we bring the pennant to Boston, their first since 1918.
Well, Joe, if you bring home that old bacon, I'll cook it for you.
Atta girl.
It was an astounding thing. I thought about it. The last time I ever saw my father was in his hospital room at MGH. And he said to my brother and me, don't worry. So I got to live through four world championships. You'll get one before you die. And I just kept thinking about that.
The only thing I can tell you right now, I'll guarantee you we'll have a hustling ball club, and they won't quit.
There's never a wish better than this when you only got 100 years to live. Half the time goes by, suddenly your eyes are no the blink of an eye. 67 is gone, the sun is getting high. We're moving on.
Ball hit hard to left field. Yastrzemski goes back, he looks up, it's gonna be out of here. A home run for Bucky Dent.
I'm 99 for a moment. Thank you, thank you, another moment. And I'm just dreaming, down in the woods, the way you are. 15, there's still time for you.
Little roller up along first, behind the bag.
That's the difference between baseball and all the other sports around here. If baseball lingers, that's what makes it so great.
There's never a wish better than this when you only got 100 years to live.
To the greatest Red Sox team ever.
Ever!
I think what's happened now is we believe that anything is possible, that it's not over till it's over, and that if it looks bad, you don't necessarily have to throw in the towel just yet. As long as there's still an out,
a second on the clock, things could still go our way. And I think that collective kind of change of energy and of thinking is going to make being a Boston sports fan for the next few years a lot of fun.
To left field and deep and down he goes back and it's gone! Unbelievable! That second only to Fisk in the minds of everybody in New England.
Pokes it away for Bork. The shot scores! Raymond Bork broke up the play.
The Boston Celtics select Len Bias of the University of Maryland.
Half my life's in books, written pages, living learning from fools and from sages. You know it's true. All the things come back to you.
Just holds it. He says, I concede.
And the Boston Celtics with the greatest fourth quarter comeback in NBA playoff history.
Yeah,